اهلا وسهلا بكم في المنتدى الثقافي في ديربون. Welcome everyone to Dearborn Cultural Forum and Open Mic. مرت سنة على تأسيس المنتدى الثقافي في ديربون الذي كان ولا يزال هدفه أن يقيم للغة العربية علما ويرصف للشعر العربي ساحة يستخرج إليها الثقافة المبطونة في بيوت الجالية العربية الأمريكية ويواسي اللغة العربية في غربتها وهي تنادي على لسان شاعر النيل حافظ إبراهيم أيهجرني قومي عفى الله عنهم إلى لغة لم تتصل برواتي سرت لوثة الإفرنج فيها كما سرى لعاب الأفاعي في مسيل فراتي فجاءت كثوب ضم سبعين رقعة مشكلة الألوان مختلفات وأيضا يريد المنتدى أن يبني جسور الحوار الأدبي بين الشرق والغرب وبين الأصالة والتجديد وبين الجيل الأول والجيل الثاني بل وحتى الجيل الثالث في المغترب ولذلك كانت للغة الإنجليزية حصتها كلغتنا الجديدة في بلدنا الجديد من التعبير عما يخلد في الذات العربية الأمريكية من آمال وما يطفو على وجدانها من ذكريات وما تتأواه من هموم وحرص مجموعة من الأخوة الذين تنبض أرواحهم بحب الأدب وعشق الثقافة على أن يساهموا في الحفاظ على المنتدى وتنميته فشكلوا لذلك لجنة إدارية تجتمع شهرياً لتنظيم المنتدى وفعالياته وهم الأخ الأستاذ رفعت المندوي السيد علي السندي سعادة الدكتور السفير علي عجمي الأستاذ الدكتور حسن بزي السيدة حنان شرارة والأستاذ الدكتور كامل بزي فنشكرهم باسم الجالية العربية على هذه الجهود المشكورة كما ونشيد بالمتحف العربي الأمريكي على استضافته الكريمة للمنتدى بكل رحابة صدر وسعة نفس علماً بأننا جنديان في خندق واحد هو خندق الثقافة العربية الأمريكية والمنتدى الثقافي يرحب بالحضور الكريم ويشجع أبناء الجالية على المشاركة ويهتم المنتدى بتسجيل وتدوين ونشر ما يقدمه المشاركون حتى يقدم عربون محبة لجميع مريدي الثقافة في العالم وأيضاً وهو الأهم يقوم بدور تاريخي للحفاظ على هذا التراث اللغوي وتقديمه بحلة إعلامية تصويرية والآن أقدم لكم أحد أعمدة المنتدى الثقافي ليقدم لنا محاضر اليوم له في كل قلب من أبناء الجالية نصيباً من الحب والتقدير وفي كل لقاء من لقاءاتها نصيباً من المشاركة والمؤازرة خدم العلم أستاذاً والثقافة صحفياً وكاتباً والوطن سفيراً والعربية شاعراً والآن يختم الإنسانية ناشطاً اجتماعياً ومنظماً لمنابر الثقافة والحوار يطول الكلام فيه إذا انطلق اللسان ثم لا نصل إلا إلى شاطئ من التجارب قد خاض هو عمق محيطه أقدم لكم الدكتور السفير علي عجمي
السلام عليكم Wissam didn't mention himself as a part of the managing board of directors. Huh? I don't know why you... Anyhow, I want to thank each and every one of you, mainly the newcomers. I want to thank our Consul General of Lebanon, Ms. Susan. You're most welcome. Amjad, you're most welcome. I want to thank Dr. Ned Fawaz also for being here, and all the rest of the friends. I know that Sally Howell had understood every word Mustafa was, Wissam was saying, be well aware, she speaks Arabic perfectly well.
Not like that, sorry.
Because she understands Arabic perfectly well. Probably.
Yeah.
Sounds like too much bass.
Okay, before introducing our lecture, I want to mention something. We usually hold our sessions every first Wednesday of the month. But due to the holy month of Ramadan, which will start, I think, 15th or 16th of this month, so the next session will be on the third Wednesday of June, which will be on the 20th. And our lecturer will be also a professor, well known among most of you. Her name is Dr. Christine Ajrouch. She is a professor of sociology in the Eastern Michigan University, and she will be talking about effective strategies to help youth cope with prejudice and discrimination. That's for next month. Now to Dr. Sally Howell. I know that you know most of those who are present, and I know a lot of them know you very well. But Dr. Saleh Howell is the director of the Center for Arab American Studies and associate professor of history at the University of Michigan, Dearborn. She had her bachelor's degree in Middle East Studies from Davidson College. Where is this Davidson College?
The North Carolina.
Okay. She had her master's degree in American culture from University of Michigan. And in the year 2009, she received her PhD from the American Culture Program at University of Michigan. She had written and co-written many books, included Citizenship and Crisis, Arab Detroit 9/11, Life in the Terror Decade, 2011, and which is the most important book she had written about, Old Islam in Detroit, Rediscovering the Muslim American Past. And this book was named a Michigan Notable Book by the Library of Michigan and given the Evelyn Shaker or Shakir?
Shaker.
Evelyn Shaker Award by the Arab American National Museum. Professor Howell is currently completing a book entitled Halal, Why Halal? You'll tell us about that later. Halal Metropolis, Mosque, Markets, and Neighborhood Development, which explores the mutual constitution of local publics and religious minorities across the urban and suburban landscape in Michigan. Please help me welcome Professor Dr. Sally Howell.
Thank you very much. I'm flattered to be here. My Arabic is not. I'd say I speak, you know, maybe Ashurim and Maya, so I can't really give a talk in Arabic. So I want to make sure I have my clock on so I don't talk too long. So it's sort of awkward for me to give this lecture here because presumably you are the history of the Arab community in Dearborn and the Lebanese community in Dearborn, and it's kind of awkward for me to try and do this here. Ideally, you know quite a bit more about the history than I do. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give sort of a summary and overview of the history of the Arabs in Dearborn. And can you see the screen over here? No, are you okay?
We have to meet to move the podium from here, if it's possible.
Yeah, I want to move it back a little bit. More than anything, I don't even need the microphone, but you need. So, of course, the history of the Arab community in Dearborn, just like anywhere else in Michigan, begins in one place. It begins at the intersection of Woodward Avenue in Manchester and Highland Park, Michigan. I love these pictures. This is the Ford Motor Company. It was in 1914 when he offered his $5 workday. In 1912, there's a recording that Sheikh Khalil Bazi did with Alexa Knapp, a historian, that she recorded from him in the 1960s, where he talks about His brother had come to America before him with someone from the Turfey family. And they lived on, I can't think of the name of the street now, LaBelle, which was on the other side of Woodward from Manchester. And when he came to America, he didn't speak any English. His brother had sent him money for the passage, and he got off the boat at Ellis Island, and he had a big badge that his brother had sent for him that said, you know, from Ellis Island, take the streetcar to the train station, take this train to Cleveland, take that train to Detroit, get off. And here, his badge ended at this exit from the streetcar in Manchester. So he got off the streetcar, and he was very anxious. What am I going to do? Once I get off the streetcar, how am I going to find my brother? And he said, I got off the streetcar right here, at this intersection right here. And he said, he looked around, and everyone spoke Arabic. They were all Arabs. They were all from Vintage Bay. He was so happy. So people took him to his brother's house. So this Highland Park factory was a center for all the new immigrants who were arriving in Michigan, and really the new immigrants who were arriving in America at this time. They heard about this $5 workday and they came to Detroit. This is Robert Taylor and Henry Ford, who were, sort of modernizing and really revolutionizing the labor force here in America. These are the kinds of people who worked here. The Highland Park factory had over 12,000 workers. This was like really revolutionary for the economy of the world, that you could have these workers, instead of building a car, like one car at a time, they started just doing the assembly line production, and they could make hundreds of cars a week. But look at the percentage of that workforce. Three quarters of it was foreign born. So it wasn't just the Lebanese who were arriving here at this time, right? All these different groups were arriving. The group on the left were the majority of the people who came to Detroit in this period. And when we think about Detroit today, it's a really Polish city. There were a lot of Russians here. There were a lot of Romanians, Italians, Hungarians. The group on the right, these were the Muslims. There were also a lot of Muslims who were coming in this period. Turks, Kurds, Syrians, Albanians, Indians. There were Polish, the Tatars, Polish Muslims, Russian Muslims, Lithuanian Muslims.